Are pit bulls misunderstood? This is the number of dog-related fatalities between the years 2005 and 2017. As you can see, there's a vast number between the first place and the second place. What can you see in common between all these breeds? Don't worry, we'll get back to this. Here at Dog Law, we know that while facts can be quite convincing and are used to prove a specific point, there are always exceptions or issues that can be confusing for all of the opinions that are out there. In the dogdom, there's no other dog that can cause more polarizing opinions than the pit bull. Before we continue, make sure to subscribe to the channel and ring the bell to be the first to watch our most recent videos. Now, before we talk about all of this, we want to clear up the fact that we're referring to all four breeds that the term pit bull encloses: the American Pit Bull Terrier, American Staffordshire Terrier, American Bully, and Staffordshire Bull Terrier. Now, some people include the American Bulldog in this group of breeds, but we're leaving it outside for a reason we'll discuss later on. Over the last few years, let's say the last 5 to 10 years, there's been some sort of awareness regarding the false impression the pit bulls give, and more people are embracing pit bulls as house pets. But is this truly and completely a false impression? Let's take a look. Ever since social media has been popularized and used by everyone, it's quite simple for anybody to show any kind of content around the world. Because of this, the so-called myth of the pit bull being aggressive and dangerous as a breed has been lowered, and people are gaining awareness of this. Of course, this is in comparison to the last 20 years, but still, we have a long way to go. There are hundreds of videos online about an aggressive and abandoned pit bull that had been used in dogfights and raised cruelly and harshly, and then has been brought into a more normal, loving family that raises the pit bull with patience and warmth. Usually the result is a success. The pit bull stops attacking people and other dogs and is shown to be a passive dog and just wants to play around with anybody that he meets. But the internet doesn't have all of the pieces of the evidence. Everybody knows someone that owns a pit bull, with many people even having visited a house guarded by a pit bull and noticed that it has goofy, playful and loving energy. Most of the pit bull owners will tell you that they're terrible guarding dogs because all they want to do is be pet by the new person in the house. Now, we can't ignore the alarming numbers this issue involves. Going back to the chart previously shown, we see that an alarming number of 284 fatal attacks were carried out by pit bulls. Some cases show pit bulls attacking their owners. Sometimes they attack strangers. We understand that this is the result of poor ownership and harsh breeding. Not to mention the fact that the four pit bull breeds and the American Bulldog all rank amongst the top 10 breeds used in dogfighting in the US, and the four pit bull breeds appear in a lot of top 10 charts in different countries around the world. But one cannot avoid asking why the difference is so vast. There are other breeds used in dogfighting, such as the Rottweiler, Boxer, Dobermans, and the German Shepherds, and yet the difference between the first and the second is almost 250 attacks. Well, first of all, we have to explain something crucial. All of the breeds appearing in the chart have something in common. They're all big, powerful dogs. The accurate story this chart gets across is that these dogs have been responsible for most attacks because they have more capability of causing harm than other breeds, not necessarily that they are naturally more aggressive than other dogs. For example, if you take a Maltese and any breed of pit bull and have them both attack someone, the former wouldn't cause even half the harm of the latter. This is why we emphasize that this chart or our previous top 10 list, or any top 10 lists you see that's counting down the top picks for dangerous dogs, all of those videos and articles are listing the dogs that have the potential to cause more harm. And yet, the question remains. Why are all these statistics showing pit bulls being responsible for 5 times more attacks than the rest of the breeds? Studies of the population might show an answer. In December 2019, the American Kennel Club registered over 90 million dogs, but there's no conclusive population count of every breed. However, they registered German Shepherds occupied 6.3% of the US dog population. If this is true, and according to the ASPCA data population that estimated the pit bull type population is 3.6 times higher by intake than German Shepherds, an estimated 20% of the dog population, that's around 18 million, proves that pit bull breeds are the most populated in the US. That could be the answer. Pit bulls are seen attacking people more so than any other breed because there aren't as many dogs like pit bulls, and they happen to be the ones most commonly used in dogfighting. Of course, since pit bulls are commonly used for dogfighting, published peer-reviewed studies in authoritative journals of psychology and forensic science established that pit bull owners as a whole, statistically, are more likely to be socially deviant, engage in crimes involving children, domestic violence, alcohol abuse, and violent crimes against other persons. Therefore, a pit bull raised in that environment could adopt this undesirable behavior. Regardless of the reason, the numbers are a crucial factor for this fear towards pit bulls, and this fear leads to several consequences. For example, number one, we said there have been more videos showing that pit bulls are not naturally aggressive and gaining awareness, but this is only a small population of people. As of 2020, there are 41 countries with pit bull bans or restrictions. Number two, the American Pit Bull Terrier is the number one breed available for adoption in shelters, meaning that they are the breed that is most taken in shelters and least adopted. Of course, despite many regions that are trying to ban the pit bull, a few are trying to break the stigma. Many people even take pit bulls as therapy dogs, and they fit perfectly for that job. There are many testimonies of people going through an issue, having themselves a therapy dog, and having that dog completely turn their life around for the better. Nobody can deny the attacks, but the fact remains that there are roughly 18 million pit bulls in the US, with most of them being as lovable, loyal, and safe as any other breed. Early socialization, positive training, and a lot of patience. Every dog is different, but no dog is born being bad. You can quote us on that. What do you think? Have you had a good or a bad experience with a pit bull? Let us know in the comments. Tell us if you want us to cover more topics like this. See you next time.